Hey guys, what's up? I'm Mark, and in this channel, I talk a little bit about lifestyle, but we mostly talk about business and investments. We won't get into the particulars that we usually cover from week to week, but in today's video, I really just wanted to thank you guys for getting me through the 5,000 subscriber mark. When I started this during the pandemic, I didn't really think that I would get here. I also even told myself that I was just gonna enjoy the journey. If I don't even get monetized, if I don't reach that 1,000 subscriber mark, I was fine with it. So I'm so happy now that even if it's quite small in the wide world of YouTube, I am very thankful for me to be able to reach this milestone of 5,000 subscribers. And with this 5,000 subscriber milestone, I'm actually celebrating my 40th birthday also in several weeks. So no, I'm not doing a birthday giveaway. But what I wanted to share today was not so much my YouTube journey, but really my entire journey as a whole. Now that I'm turning 40, I feel like I should share a little bit about myself, my profession, and all my ups and downs, my struggles. I did not envision myself to become a YouTuber. So I guess what I'm sharing here today would be what are the things that I've actually done, what have been my struggles, and what are the different roles that I've delved into in my 20-year working life. Are you guys ready for some story time telling today? Let's go! So again, since I'm turning 40, I wanted to cover what it's been like in my 20s, 30s. Again, if you're watching this and you're needing to get some, I don't know, motivation or a different dose of what you usually hear, then hope you can stay around for this. So let's start in my early 20s, graduating college. I actually started in a marketing position for a company that was owned by Smart Telecommunications. This was during the time of SMS, and we called it mobile apps then, but it was really all text messaging anyway, horoscopes, what have you. So I stayed in that first job for about 2 years. I enjoyed just being out there, you know, earning your own money. But I left that job because I went to work for our then family business. So our family was in the business of having retail stores and a bit of manufacturing. And at our peak, we had a few dozen stores. But when I joined mid-2000s, we were already starting to be in a crisis. So that's why I actually joined in. My mom told me if I wanted to help out. And of course, I obliged. I mean, the family business was, you know, the thing that had nurtured me, kept me alive all those years. So I wanted to do that just to give back. So since I was coming from an academic background of IT, so I joined more on the back office, the admin part of our family business. IT, HR, and, you know, all the support departments. I finally got a chance to also be in a more front-end part of the business. So that was mid-2000s to the early 2010s. So in total, I actually spent 6 years. But the hard part there was that, you know, after those 6 years, our family business ultimately went bust. I was faced now with the reality of what to do. I did have my own commitments and, you know, bills were coming in. I was faced with the decision to go back to corporate. From VP to assistant manager, took a huge pay cut in my salary just so that I would finally be regularly earning again. So it was a very confusing time. I had to eat a lot of humble pie. So from an executive position that I had so many direct reports, I wasn't even managing anyone just yet. So I ended up working for a bank. And I did all that just as I was about to turn 30. So now you know why turning 40, this milestone, is quite important to me. So I was 29. I had pretty much lived a charmed life at that point. But having everything taken away from me, from us, was really more than just the rug pulled underneath my feet. It was really a disorienting time. Honestly, if I had to live it all over again, I probably wouldn't want to. So my 20s were really characterized by being in corporate for a short time and being in the family business for most of the time, but being back in corporate just as I was rounding out my 20s decade. So alongside our family business closing, I also closed a small operation that I was running. My operation was called Lap Dance Bags. Lap Dance Bags was about laptop bags. I know it's cheeky and I got away with it in the mid-2000s. I will actually share one of my interviews in Click the City from more than a decade ago. So this was just a brand that sort of spun off from the family business, and we were working with a lot of the Apple stores then. We had our own kiosk, but since this was pretty much tied into the family business and its resources, you know, it ultimately made sense just to shut it down. Aside from the family business going bust, I also closed my first business. So again, saying that it was difficult might be such an understatement. So yes, we move on to my 30th year and my 30s. The first half of my 30s were also heavily invested in corporate life. Again, I had to retrace my steps, understand how it is to work with different people, people who were younger, more talented, more educated. And during my more than half decade back in corporate, I ended up working in 4 different jobs. From the bank, I moved to a telco company again. From telco, I worked with a startup in e-commerce. And from e-commerce, I moved to entertainment. Not an entertainer myself, but I was in the biggest media company in the Philippines then. So it was really interesting times. Why did I move so often? Being in business is something that, you know, once you get the taste of, it's really hard to get rid of. And I think I was just always searching for that. It's ironic, but I always thought that being employee, being corporate, was not sustainable for me. I personally felt that if I'm in business, as tumultuous as it could be, I always felt more secure when I knew I could earn my own money, even if the business might fail or bust. With all that job hopping, the opportunity came when my condo got turned over, and ultimately, I couldn't pay for it. I couldn't pay for it, and I turned it into an Airbnb. And that's when things started to snowball. I started doing it for friends, and I dove into doing this in Palawan. It was a small setup in terms of, you know, resorts or lodging and accommodations. But I dove in, got out of corporate again, and it was actually good. 2019 was my first full year being a full-time entrepreneur, and I thought it would go on forever. But then the pandemic hit and pretty much wiped out my entire business again. And in those dark times, I was actually thinking if I should go back to corporate. But I think being older, being in my late 30s at this point, I made up my mind once and for all that, you know, I couldn't be invested in things that were completely different. Like, I had to choose a path and stay in that path. And it meant, you know, eating away into my savings during the pandemic, not having any Airbnb. At the peak of the pandemic, that's when my YouTube channel was born. And yes, it did get started with just really random topics. And it was a frustrating journey. It took me almost 2 years before I got monetized. So I really put in the work doing videos every week. Most videos were off. I think I had a few gems in a few videos. I'm not a very patient guy. I don't like to edit, watch things all over again. But I stuck through it. And right now, even though I wouldn't consider YouTube as one of my main sources of income, I'm just happy to say that it is a source of income. Small enough for it not to be taxed just yet. So we slowly grew out of the pandemic. One by one, my Airbnb started coming back. I was starting to juggle it with YouTube. And now I'm here. Now my Airbnbs are back in full swing. The Palawan Airbnb reopened as well. And this YouTube channel is starting to really get some traction. And even as I haven't earned so much from YouTube, I've actually been very happy, very fortunate to have met some of you. Some of you have entrusted me to run your property as an Airbnb. So it's funny how that sort of just worked out. Like Steve Jobs say, you can only connect the dots looking back. But it's hard to say what you're doing when you are facing forward, dabbling into different things. A lot of things make sense when you look back. So again, thank you for bringing this channel to where it is now. And also, I'm thankful for the pandemic being eased out and I could go back to my love of Airbnb and travel. So I'm sharing all these with you. Again, hoping that if you are like me and perhaps you are going through a struggle, a career change, perhaps you want to leave your job, perhaps there is something that you really want to get into for so long but have always been fearful, I hope that you get something from this video. I can't give you the advice to jump, to leap, to leave behind what you don't want anymore, I can't tell you to resign. But what I can tell you is to dabble in the things that you want to get into. I did my Airbnb stuff while I was working. I would reply to guests in the office. So do put in your time to do things that you want to do. If you want to be a Lazada seller, if it's a talent that you want to hone, I advise you to start getting into it. Put in a little bit of your time. If it's business that you want to get into, then get your feet wet with whatever business that you may come across. A lot of these things are just practice until it's finally time to shine through. For me, what's next? Actually, don't know. But again, I trust that where I'm going will be revealed and it will make sense in the long run. I honestly don't know what to do with this YouTube channel because it's growing, but it will require additional work. So I want to figure that out. And I do love hosting guests, talking about travel. So I will continue to do that. For the things that I'm not yet into, but I want to get into, Airbnb is actually a subfacet of the larger real estate industry business that I want to get into. So putting it out there, that's something that I want to get into. And another thing that I want to dabble more into would be studying wine. I mean, more than just messing around with my wine videos, I actually want to get certified. Again, I don't know how it will fit into my plans, but let's see. Let's see what will eventually get revealed to us. What are the plans that this universe has for us? So that's about it. Again, I hope you found this helpful, whether in part or as a whole. I hope there's something here that I've been able to share, and I hope you can let me know what are the plans that you want to get into, and putting it out there without fearing of what the world may say or what struggles that may lay before you. I think just put it out there and let's see, hopefully whatever they are, that you get them and you get to them sooner or later. If you've liked this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and consider subscribing if you haven't already. Thanks again for watching, guys, and see you next time.